Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be the next video in my graduate application series. Today's video I'm going to be talking to you about creating a CV or curriculum vitae, and I'm going to be focusing on this video creating a CV for an academic setting. The CV can be very particular depending on what you're creating it for. When I created my CV, was creating it for the forensic science field, and there are still remnants of that in my CV that I've left, and I left for my application to grad school because they're reminiscent of academia. There's definitely some different focuses that you want to have when you're looking at academic CVs. In case you're wondering, a CV is a very particular snapshot of your history relating to a specific area. A lot of people ask the question of, like, what's the difference between a CV and a resume? And it's kind of how, like, a resume, you would put all of your past work experience, relevant and not often. But a CV is really geared towards your relevant experience. Also, it can be tailored towards, with like the academic setting, you're going to tailor towards research and teaching experience, like academic higher education teaching experience, and less towards general work experience. Work experience can be in the academic field or in a research field, but those would include, but it's just not always the focus. So for this video, I'm actually going to take you through a CV, and this CV is one that I created as an example. It actually is modified from my own CV so that I can speak to points that were in my own CV for my application, just so you can get an idea of the process behind creating an academic CV.
So now you're all seeing a CV, which is modified from my own CV that I used to apply for grad school. And you'll see here the structure of the CV and the contents that I have included. At the top of the CV is the name and contact information section. In this section, you'll see the name is the largest, followed by phone number, email address, and current mailing address. It's important to keep this section up to date so that it is easy for people to contact you. The last thing you want is for them to try and contact you and not be able to. The order of the rest of the sections can shift a little depending on how you are tailoring your CV. As I mentioned, for this video, the CV is focused on grad school applications and the order I personally have my sections in. The next section I have is education, which I list all of my education. This includes my bachelor's and master's degree. I've also included my GPA, honors distinction, and the degrees that I received. My GPA and honors distinction I feel help me stand out from the crowd, and the degrees can be important if it's a specific request of a program you're applying for. The next section I've included is honors and awards. In this section, I would say include all relevant information. For me, mine are not directly related to my field of interest and are from my undergraduate years. However, I am proud of these distinctions, and the distinction of my aviation scholarship has become somewhat of a talking point through interviews and advisor chats. The next section is research and laboratory experience. My personal examples were my graduate research project and my internship in the forensic laboratory. This section can and should include any research experience you have, including a research assistantship, internship, or work experience. In the this section, I also included specific points of what I actually did during my research projects as a way to highlight the work that I did and give those who would be viewing my CV a better idea of my research projects. The next section I have is teaching experience. I kept this relevant to higher education academia and only included my adjunct faculty teaching position during my master's. You could also include teaching assistantship experiences. I know sometimes undergraduates and graduate students will have teaching assistantships that would go well in this section. The next section I have is relevant coursework. And this section is highly optional for an academic CV. I personally have this included from my CV being tailored to a forensic science career field, since many forensic science jobs require specific coursework. This section also, I want to point out, is not a complete list of my coursework. It is tailored towards my relevant areas of research and those required courses for forensics. This section could easily be left out, as many programs will require you to submit transcripts, which they'll be able to see all of your coursework on that. The next section I have is technical training. And this was another crossover from my CV being for the forensic industry. However, this can also be a very good section to include for research positions, because they will want to see your differing experiences with technical training. I have two subheadings in this section. The first subheading is instrumental experience. In this section, I listed every single instrument that I had personally operated during my master's. This was a suggestion from one of my professor mentors, who told me that if I operated it, I should include it. The next subheading is analytical experience. Here is listed all of the procedures and kits that I, again, personally performed. Note that both of these sections, I include a disclaimer that this was performed in the classroom environment. All of my experience was during class or a graduate school research project. I potentially could separate these into ones I used for research and internship and those that I used in classroom, since this would give a clearer picture of my experience with them. However, this could also get very complicated, and I wanted to keep this section a little bit simpler. The next section I have is work experience. For me, this section is not relevant to the field that I was entering. And I personally decided to include it for a number of very important reasons. The first is because I was in a supervisory role during my gap career, and this role provided me with valuable leadership experience and knowledge that is relevant to new roles I'm applying for. Also, since I did have several gap years, I wanted to demonstrate what I was doing and working on during those gap years. I want to note I did not include all of my part-time jobs, and I only included the ones that were relevant and the one that I felt would enhance my application. The next section included is clubs, services, and associations. Again, with this section, relevance can come into play. However, it can also be good to represent yourself as a whole, well-rounded person. For example, I spent a year as a reading tutor with the Reading Corps, and I am very proud of that service year. I also served as a board member on my undergraduate Aero Club, which again represents my leadership experience. I have stopped including items from my high school experience, since this has become far removed from where I am now. However, depending on where you are in your life process, you could potentially include these items as well. Be sure to be a little particular about what you're including in these sections. Admissions committees are going to see a ton of CVs, and you want yours to stand out from the pack. But you also want it to be a full representation of you. You don't want so much information that they can't wade through it all and find what they are looking for. You should not put anything on your CV that you're not willing to talk about in an interview. Anything will be fair game. I hope seeing this CV and how I have things laid out for you has been helpful. I do want to point out that there is one section that I have nothing to contribute to and thus was not added to my CV, and this is a section about publications or conference presentations. I unfortunately do not have any publications as of yet, and while I've attended professional conferences, I have not presented at one. As a result, this section was left off my CV. However, if you do have experience in either of these areas, it is a very valuable section to include in your CV, as this can be highly regarded by admissions committees for graduate school.
So now that we've gone over all the sections that you're going to want to include in your CV and a little bit more details about them, a couple of points that I want to make about it is if you're in school right now and you have resources available to you like a career center, I highly suggest asking them for help. They can be amazing resources, but also I suggest that you ask your professors who are your mentors. You know, remember when I was talking to you about getting to know your professors for letters of recommendation? Well, this is another reason to get to know them, because they can be amazing mentors to help you guide you through your CV. They can critique it for you. I personally was able to have amazing professor mentors in grad school, my master's, who our focus of our master's program was creating CVs, so they were able to peer review my CV, or rather review it, and this was just a great resource because they are in the field of academia, they are professors, they are going to know what these programs are looking for, and that way they were able to help me tailor mine towards the right field. So if you also know somebody in the field you're going into, you may want to have them look at it for you and give you some advice. Finally, I want to say that make sure anything that you include in your CV, you are willing to talk about and able to talk about. For example, in the technical instrumental analysis portion, if you say that you've worked with an instrument or an analytical process, please make sure that you're able to speak towards that. At least speak towards how you've used it, what you understand about it. If you're going to put it on your CV, you should know about it. And this goes with other things also. My CV is very unique in that I left some things on there not related to STEM academia, or at least my STEM field directly. With that, I had an aviation scholarship, and I was involved in an aero club. And these were topics that surprisingly came up every single interaction I had through this grad school so far. It was asked in my interview about it, and just generally, and it was asked in my advisor interviews, where anybody who saw my CV was like, oh, have you flown an airplane? And I guess I wasn't expecting it, but it's unique, and so that's why I say just make sure that you're prepared to talk about it. If it's on your CV, you should talk about it. I hope this series has been helpful for you so far. Please let me know if there's anything more specific